Hello and welcome to HackerRank Interview Preparation Kit playlist. Currently we are at the stack section. We have solved problems till the DP. So I'll add the link here so you can go and watch the rest of the problems. So I thought rather than going for the stacks problem directly, we can go ahead and learn some basics for the stack. So if anyone is new here or new to the data structure, can gain insight from this particular video. So let's start. What I'll do is I'll try to answer this particular WH question. So I hope that will make sense and you can get more information by using such questions. So we'll try to answer what is stack, why stack, how or when stack will be used. So let's get started. Let's start with the stacks. So what basically stack is? Stack is nothing but a data structure, and it is an abstract data structure. I mentioned it as a linear data structure. What linear data structure means? It is in the sequential manner. You can take values in the sequence form. You can either take out the values in the sequence form. You can push the values in the sequence form. So this is the linear data structure. Also, it can be also called as an abstract data structure. And what abstract data structure means is it is different than the user defined data structure, where we can, in the user defined, we had like structures, class. In the abstract data structures, we have like stacks, queues, and so on. After that, we have the LIFO principle, that is last in, first out. I hope everyone is familiar with it. So this, if anyone do not know, this will be a last in, first out. So what it means is, let's say this is the basic example of stack. This is stack of books. The value which was placed last will be taken out first. This is the basic example of last in, first out. So let's say you have to access this particular value or this particular book. What you need to do is you have to remove these many number of books from it, and after that only you can access this book. And after that, what basically stack is, an array with extra step. So if you watch Rick and Morty, you will get this particular analogy, what array with extra steps means. And we'll see how you can implement stack using array with those basic steps. So let's get started and learn more about this. So let me go ahead and bring the new slide. So this is like what I told you. So this will be a linear data structure or abstract data structure. Currently it is an empty. So you will have some functions, that is push. So what push function will do? It will push the values into the stack. Similarly, again, we are using push function. So every time we are pushing the values, it will be stored into the stack. And the pop is the basic function, and I think this slide is misplaced. This should be the next slide, but that's not the issue. So let's go ahead and see the next slide. So I first I wanted to discuss these things and then show you too, but no issues. So what basically pop means is delete or take out. So we have to perform this particular operation. After that we have push. Push means insert the values. So what I can do instead is, rather than writing here, I can create a basic stack. So let's say this is the stack. Let's say I have some values here. If I need to push the values into the stacks, we will use push function. If we need to take out the values from the stack, we will use the pop function. And the next function is peek. What we mean by peek is, let's say at some point in your coding life or in real time example, you will need to get the top value. What is the top value? So in that case, you can use the peek function. What peek function will provide you is the top of the stack value. So I hope these three functions are clear, and we saw the basic explanation what inserting is, what deleting is, and these are the standard function name which will be used in your stack library, C++ STL stack library, or you can there is no requirement of using that library. You can directly create stack with array, so it's very easy. So let's move ahead and see some more stuff. So after this, we will see how stack can be implemented. So we have two ways. We can either go with array, which we saw, we have discussed. And there is one more way to go with stack is, that is a linked list. So in linked list, what will happen is, let's say you have this particular linked list. So what you will do is, in stack, we have this particular principle, that is LIFO, where all the operation will be performed on one end only. So that particular end could be in the start or could be in the end. So let's say this is the particular linked list. So both the operation of inserting and deleting will be done at last end. So if let's say if I need to add or push the values, so what I'll do is I'll add a new list or new linked list object to it and then add its reference to this particular value. So this will be a like a push value or the push operation. Similarly, if I need to let's say pop this particular value, what I'll do, I'll assign this reference value or the pointer value to null. So that means our pop operation will be done. So I hope you got the logic of implementation using linked list. I will not go into detail with the linked list because that's over engineering for the stack. We will see the detailed implementation using the array. So let's go ahead and see how we can do the stack implementation using array. So let me clear the clutter and move it. So let's start. So let's say this is our basic array. Let's take any random value. Let's say go with 5 containers. So let's assume this is our array and we need to convert this particular array into the stack. So generally if you see anywhere, stack is generally represented in the vertical format. Why? Because it gives us the feeling of top and bottom. So that's the one of the thing that why we use stack vertically. And I don't think there is any more concrete reason similarly like why we use I in the for loops. There is no direct explanation why people use stack vertically, but I think the reason could be of top. So let's say we have a variable that is top. So let me go ahead and write here. Top variable will be doing is it will show us the top value, or it will be a basic pointer pointing to the next value or top value. So a basic pointer, or you can write it as anywhere. So it will basically point at the next value or the top value. So this is like first operation. And in the initialization, we will initialize this particular value to the -1. After that, we will have size of array. So size will be, let's say, as of now, we have array with 5 elements. So this will be 5. So let's say we have size that is 5. We have a top variable, which is currently is pointing at -1. So what -1 will be? There is no value. So what this particular represent is, this is 0, this is 1, this is 2, 3 and 4, right? So top is currently pointing to the -1. So that means it is an underflow statement. We do not have anything or any value here. So we will again discuss what is underflow and overflow. So bear with me. So we'll discuss everything one by one. So let me go ahead and clear this values. So let's start. Now what we are going to do, we have the top value, which is currently pointing at -1. We have size. So for each instance, we will first check if our top is not getting higher than that of size. So let's say if your top is at this particular position, we have done certain operation. Let's say our top is now at 4. So we want to check if our top is, let's say, this particular condition. So let me go ahead and write it so there should not be any confusion. If this particular condition is true, this should be like less than, more of less than that of size -1. So you can see we have size that is 5, and when we will hit this particular value that is 4, and if let's say our top is equal to 4, this will be the last condition where we can perform a push operation. After that, let's say our top points at 5 value. In that case, because we do not have any size to push that particular element here, this particular operation will not be entertained. So the first condition will be to check this condition. So let me go ahead and highlight this. So we will check this condition. If our top is less than that of the size -1, in that case only we will do the certain operation, that is of push. And similarly we will see the pull operation. So I hope I have given the basic idea, like what is the initialization with size, initialization of top, and what will be the basic condition, that is if top is less than equal to size -1, in that case only we will do the operation. So let's go ahead and let's look at the push and pop operations. So let me clear this, or let's move ahead. Okay, so this is the basic operation which I was telling you about, that is pushing elements. So here if you see, we will again draw the same thing. So let's consider this. So currently our top is pointing at minus 1. We have saw why it is and how we will go ahead from the here. After that, we will check if our top is equal to size minus 1. If that is the case, means we have completed all the sizes and we cannot push anymore. In that case only, we will output or we will print out, that is, this is the overflow condition. Our stack is full. We cannot do any operation here. So after that, we will check in else loop. What we will simply do is, we will add one value. So what I can do is, I can add one value. So let's say I push a next value here. After pushing a new value, I'll increment the top. So currently my top will point at this particular value. So top will be 0. After this, I'll push the value of, like, let's say value, I had the value of 5. So I'll push the particular value here in the stack. After that, we will we can print out that insertion was successful. This is not really necessary, but because I wrote the code earlier, so this is how we'll do it. So let's take example of, let's say I have already inserted 5. So let's go with 5 4 3 2 1. I need to insert these particular values into the stack. So we have done with 5. After that, we will come with 4. For 4, we'll go and check if our top is equal to size minus 1. No, our top is currently at 0. That means I can do a push operation. So I'll come here, I'll add value, that is 4. I'll increment our top. So this will be 1. So top will be pointing here, right? And after that, again, one more insertion was successful. Similarly, after that, 3 will become, after insertion of 3, top will be incremented to 2. And after this, similarly, same value again, until the point where, let me go ahead and draw it, 2 and 1. So in this case, it will be top 3 is, or top 4. So at this condition, our top is at 4. So let's say I have to again add any more variable or value, that is 0. In that case, I cannot add it. It will be basically an overflow situation. Our stack will be full and we cannot do it anymore. I hope you got this particular logic. And if you have any issues, do let me know in the comments. I'll be happy to clear it there. After looking at the pushing element or the push operation, let's go ahead and learn pop operation. So let me clear this and we can move ahead there. So like pulling elements or pulling out the elements. So let's again draw the same value here. We, let's say, fill the stack first. The same condition will be, let's say if my top is at minus 1, this means I do not have any value in the stack. So in that case, I cannot take out any more values. So this will be underflow condition. Our stack will be empty and we cannot do the pull operation. So this will be the one case of underflow. We saw what was overflow. Overflow was like pushing the elements when the stack was full. Underflow is popping out the element when the stack is empty. And if this is not the case, we can go ahead and delete the elements. So what we mean by deleting elements is, we simply decrement the top value. Let's say I have to delete this particular element. I will not go ahead and delete this element and then rearrange all the array value. I'll simply do is changing the top value. So let's say we have the top value of 3, 2, 1, 0. I'll simply put top value to be 2. So next time, let's say anyone comes for the top value of array, so our new array or new stack will be starting from here. In the physical world, we will not be deleting this particular character or the size will not be reduced, but in the logical ways, because we are moving top, our stack will start from this particular point. I hope you got this particular logic. This case of underflow, the case of deleted, and for each deletion, we will decrement the top. I hope that's a basic understanding. So I hope you got this particular logic. If not, do let me know. I'll be happy to assist you. After that, let's move ahead and let's do the analysis for stack. So if you see in the stack, the insertion operation. So where will the insert operation will be happening is always happening at the end. So this should not be the case. So let me draw it here. So this is my stack. I know it's not pretty, but that's what I can do best in the drawing. So this is my stack. the insert operation will be always performed at the last position. So that means my insert operation will be always O of 1. Right? So in the array, what you were doing was, let's say in this case, if you are not directly submitting the value like array and then giving the index. So if you are giving, let's say array and some index, like say 5, this would be O of 1 operation. However, let's say if you are pushing back values in the vector, that particular operation would have been O of n, right? But in the case of stack, insert will be always of O of 1. Why? It is happening at the one place only. Similarly, accessing the elements. So if you see for the accessing element, many people think it is again O of 1. Why? Because in array, what we used to do was, let's say array, and we need to get the, let's say, value of 10th place. So we used to do this, and the value would have been got in the O of 1. But this is not the case with the stack. In stack, what we are going to do is, we need to take out those many values first, and after that only we can access this particular value. So basically, the access would be O of n. After that, search is similar thing. For in order to search, you have to come across the whole values. Similarly, search will come in the terms of O of n, and this is the same for array as well. So there is no issue or the confusion. After that, let's focus on the deletion. So in deletions, if you see, we can say that the deletion operation or the insertion operation is happening at one point only. We are not touching the whole or the entire stack, but the top value. So again, deletion operation will be conducted in O of one time, and after that a space, and for space, for let's say n values, you would require of n size. So this will be of O of n. So I hope you got this particular analysis, what it means and how it is calculated. If you have any issues, do let me know in the comments. So let me clear this and move ahead. So after this, where stack generally is used. So generally stack is used to reverse a string. So this is one of the, what you can say, applications of the stack. After that, there is a parenthesis balancing or whole lot of balancing exercise where you would ask to find out if this particular characters are balanced or not. So there is one problem after this particular stack. I'll take that particular problem of parenthesis balancing from HackerRank interview preparation kit playlist, and we'll see how we can do this. After that, the evaluating of expression. So if you are from the CS background, or if you have heard earlier, that is in order, post order or postfix. So we'll do that evaluating like expression, we will evaluate them. So this is like applications or patterns where stack will be generally used. So I hope you got all the concepts. So if you have any issues, do let me know in the comments. And after this, we will solve the problems from the stack. After that, I'll try to do similar thing with the queue, and then we can go ahead and solve all the problems from the stacks and queue section. So let me know how it was. Should I continue with this kind of explanation before the problems? And thank you for watching. Have a great rest of the day.